What would it take for you to rent your vacation property in 14 minutes for the entire 2020 year and have a waiting list? You know what it's going to take from you? It's going to take a commitment for inclusion. I'm here today to open your eyes, to give you some perspective that will help you as you're looking at increasing the number of people who are renting your properties. You see, my whole premise is that inclusion is a property that sells. What I'm going to be presenting today is a case study. This case study is a Verbo property on Cape Cod in North Truro. I spoke with the owner, Leota, and in fact, this is where I got the opening. 14 minutes is all this property was open on the listing for Verbo. Within 14 minutes, she had it totally booked for next year from June until November. Now, granted, this property is on Cape Cod, and it's only a mile from town in North Truro, Massachusetts. So it's an ideal beachfront community. But what makes this special? Take a look at this property. This property is extremely wheelchair accessible. She knows from experience because her son has an extreme disability. She has provided all of the equipment necessary for a family that brings someone with a disability. The beach is accessible. The kitchen is accessible. The bathroom is accessible. Everything to get into this property is accessible. I'm going to be sharing some photos of this case study throughout this program so that you can see how the little things make a difference. That's the little nugget that you take away today, and that little things make a difference. I'm also going to be sharing with you the national demonstration home that my husband and I built and live in, the Universal Design Living Laboratory. But I think you need to understand where I come from my expertise. You're seeing a scene from a bicycle trail, the helmet that I was wearing and the headlines from that newspaper. This was on June 13th of 1998. It was my third wedding anniversary. My husband and I went out for a bicycle ride, and it was a beautiful day. Caribbean blue sky, no wind, no rain, no threat of storm. We were celebrating our love and just having a wonderful day on a Saturday in this beautiful bike trail. When all of a sudden, my husband heard what he thought was a gunshot. Of course, he got his attention and he slowed down behind me. I sped up because I heard his warning. He said, "Look over there, something's falling." And then he screamed, "Stop!" But you see, there was nothing I could do. Suddenly, a 7,000-pound tree fell on top of me, leaving me paralyzed from the waist down. That's where I got the experience of coming home for the first time in a wheelchair and understanding how limiting a house can be, how the frustration set in and how it intensified my disability.